For all those people out there considering a tablet and looking at the iPad versus every single thing else on the market, the iPad traditionally has been the tablet of choice in the last decade. However, today, guys, I'm going to show you the OnePlus Pad. This tablet, well, be honest, it's kind of a copy of the iPad. If the iPad was to have an Android child, this would probably be the tablet. Yes, today, guys, I'm going to show you this tablet, how it compares to the iPad, the different tools and accessories that come with it, like the keyboard and the pencil, and how those mark up. I'm going to show you how you can use some of the features and functions compared to those in the iPad, and how the writing experience is. So if you're someone in digital planning or note-taking, which of these devices has the better writing experience? Now, we're going to compare these devices and share our feedback with you. This is not a sponsored video. I bought both of these products independently. So if you want to hear my honest feedback, stay with me as we compare the iPad to the new OnePlus Pad. All right, so the first thing I want to get out of the room is the iPad uses the iPadOS, which is designed by Apple. It has the Apple App Store, where honestly, most apps come first. They are birthed there, they develop themselves there, and then they kind of move across the platform. So generally speaking, those that are Android users and used to using Google Play, sometimes the apps are secondary thought of. Now, when it comes to digital note-taking, for example, like OneNote is a lot superior app on the iPad versus the Android version of that is kind of scaled back a little bit. Same functionality and tools when it comes to writing, highlighting, erasing, and using lasso tools, but there's additional tools on the iPad version that just make it more functional. And we find that across the entire ecosystem when we look at different apps on Apple versus Android. Now, don't get me wrong, there's a lot of features and benefits to using Android. Their user experience and some of the tools and settings they have is just kind of one up over Apple. Apple seems to be a cleaner ecosystem that kind of gives the user kind of a flow experience versus Android kind of has a customizable experience. So that's the first thing you have to consider when you're looking at these two devices. One of them is running Apple and the other is running Android. So now let's talk about the design of these two devices. Here on the left, we have the pad. Now this is the OnePlus pad. You can see that it is kind of has a rounded curve feeling, rounded edge. It has four speakers, USB-C, again, the speakers here, power button, and then you have your volume buttons here. And then you can attach that pencil just like such. When I compare this to the framework of the iPad, you can see here, again, squared off display. It has, again, four speakers as well as the USB-C, and that pencil is attached there. Now, I will notice first and foremost that the iPad, the magnet is a lot stronger when it comes to the pencil, but again, we have the power and the volume buttons here. When I flip the devices over, you can see the camera is right here on the iPad. When I put this down on the table, even though it has a raised corner, I can evenly push across the tablet. Now, when I look at the OnePlus here, that camera is in the center. However, when I put that down on the table, depending on where I put my finger or press, there seems to be a little bit of unsteadiness. Now, this personally, I hate, absolutely hate this. I'd rather have my whole entire pad be sort of crooked or skewed, at least knowing that wherever I push on the device, it's going to like stay like stable and strong. This is really key when you're handwriting or scrolling through things. Now, when I pick up this device here, it fits in my hand really well. You can see here the bezels on here are a little thinner than what the bezel is on the iPad. When I power up this device, you can see that the bezels are a little bit wider than what they are here. Now, why are bezels on a tablet so important? A lot of times we hold the device like this, one-handed or two-handed, and having that bezel prevents us from any screen activity. So if we're going ahead and browsing the internet or swiping through apps, we're going to find that that bezel will be very convenient. But having a little bit narrower bezel also means a little bit larger display when it comes to footprint. Now, with the curved off edges of this display, I found that the overall tablet experience is pretty unique in a sense that I don't have that same issue that I would have if the bezels were any thinner, but yet I can still do one-handed and two-handed holding very easily. Now, let's talk about the pencil in general here, because I think that's really important. When I pull the pencil from the OnePlus Pad and that of the Apple Pencil, and I look at these two devices, you can see them here. They both look very similar in length. They both have the stylus tip here. And one thing that makes both of them very unique and very similar is this flat edge. I think that flat edge is very important because one, it prevents the pencil pen from rolling across your desk. It also gives you kind of a place to literally hold the pencil with your finger or thumb to kind of give you some placement when you grab it up and use it. So again, I think this is a straight up copy, but that's okay. And again, when I go ahead and put this on the device, it snaps on there. It even has the same charging symbol icon that we've known to love on the iPad. And again, it charges wirelessly, so you have that feature there as well, which is a comparable to the iPad. Another accessory that I feel that's very important when it comes to using these tablets as computer-like devices is having some type of keyboard with you. Now, when you look at the OnePlus Pad here, you can see it has a folio style case, and using those three pins across the bottom, we can go ahead and slap that and connect that here and basically have a tablet-like computer. And we can go ahead and we can use the mouse, we can type on it. And I will tell you my impression of this keyboard, the mouse responsiveness is very strong. The keyboard, very nice and snappy. It has a very strong feeling. One thing about this keyboard versus that of the Magic Keyboard, keeping in mind the Magic Keyboard is almost double the price, is it doesn't have the backlit keys. So if you were doing this in a low light condition, that might be a challenge. But if you're comparing this to the folio style tablet keyboard for the iPad, versus this one here, the price is very similar and the features are very similar. I talked before about this camera being an issue when you're handwriting and have this flat on the desk. Well, if I now have this folio cover on and flip it over and put it on the desk and I want to go ahead and write or press on a screen, it gives me that smooth, stable flexibility to do so. So when I look at the design of this device, look at the pencil, look at the keyboard, I mean, overall, there's a lot of copies there. There's a lot of similarities, but from a user standpoint, it doesn't do much for me until I get into the actual tools that I can use this. We talked about the Apple ecosystem and the different tools that come on the App Store versus the Android. Let's talk about some of the actual functionality that you use this device, such as note-taking and digital planning, and will this device have that experience that you need over that of the iPad? One of the main things I use tablets for, besides browsing the internet, watching different forms of media, is really digital note-taking. Now, if you guys haven't had a chance to get to know me yet, I'm Brandon Boner, for creator and founder of the Key to Success Planner. It's a digital planning system that works professionally and personally to help you organize the goals and aspirations in your life. And we're gonna showcase a little bit of that planner here, but if you wanna learn more about it, go ahead and hit the description. There'll be a link there. Again, I use tablets for my planning. Back in the day, I used to use Franklin Covey paper planners to really map out my life, figure out where my aspirations, my priorities were each and every day. And as we moved into the introduction of the iPad, I navigated to using digital for the main reason that wherever I go, my notes are always with me. And these tablet devices are always with me, and I can easily take digital notes. I can take notes in a meeting, I can write down thoughts and the idea, I can pull up my Galaxy Fold and be in a grocery store and mark off a list of things that I need to get. And that's what makes digital note-taking so powerful, especially when you add in the fact that I can go back into the app and search my handwritten notes. And this is quite common in OneNote and GoodNotes. Now, when it comes to digital planning, there's a whole set of different apps that you can use. And if you hit the link in the description, you're gonna see that we did a video recently showing the OnePlus Pad using a different assortment of apps. So that way, if you wanna look at digital planning or journaling and note-taking, hey, which app is best for you? Now, when I looked at this device, that is the very first thing I said to myself. Is this going to be a tablet that I can use for planning and note-taking? And initially, my answer is yes. And even today, when I look at the hardware and specs and what this device has to offer, it's still a definite yes. But there are some minor things about the iPad that probably get me to still lean into the iPad world. However, because I have such deep roots in the Apple ecosystem with FaceTime and photos and iMessage, the iPad probably is still gonna be my daily carry. But if you are someone that's looking at an Android tablet and wanting to have that iPad-like experience, this is probably the tablet for you. So let's take a look at some of those features. So I go ahead and open up the tablet itself. Again, we have that Apple-like pencil, and I can go into, say, OneNote here, and I can pull up my daily planner. Now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to jump to today's date, which is the 30th. And you can see I have my plans here in my planner. Now, what's really cool about OneNote and this device, I can go into Draw, I can go in to use this lasso tool, and I can go ahead and click these and move those around. I can copy these. So say if I didn't finish these tasks, I can go into the next day and I can disable my pencil and tap on my screen and hit paste. And now those dates are there, or those tasks are there from one day to the next, and I can easily move those back and forth. But let's talk about the writing experience, because I think that's probably what's most important. Now, one thing nice about OneNote is I have the ability to zoom in and zoom out. So if you want to go ahead and write in a smaller frame, you can do that. I'm going to go ahead and enable the pencil. Now I have different color options and different thicknesses here. I've played around with this a little bit, and I found that a little bit thicker line stroke on this device seems to work a little better. So let's go ahead and write a note. Now, the refresh rate of this screen is 144 hertz versus the iPad Pro, which is 120. So that alone gives a little bit of an edge up when it comes to writing. I think the software, though, with the iPad is a little more intuitive, and the lines that I write have a little bit more of a clear, crisp approach. If I make that line a little thinner and write, you can see that looks a little cleaner. I can go ahead and hit stop here and then tap on the screen, and that'll enable my keyboard to come up. Now I can also make that full screen, or I can also use the keyboard accessory here and type in the planner as well. When using this device, there's definitely some unique things that make it stand out over top the iPad. And one of them is if I take my two fingers and slide down the screen, it allows me to create this split screen experience. And here, if I want to go ahead and open up my browser, I now have a two-panel screen where I have my notes on the left and I have my browser on the right. Now I can go ahead and swap sides with that. I can go ahead and save the split screen, which I think is really powerful, especially the fact that if I'm looking at email or looking at browsing, I can go ahead and save the split screen. And now if I jump back to the home screen, you're gonna find that I have Chrome in OneNote as an icon here, and I can go ahead and tap and reopen that. Where that's really powerful, if you are someone that uses your email and you're constantly going through your email to look at the different to-dos that you have or the things that are on your plate for the day. So another really good example is if I have my email loaded on the left side, I can go ahead and write out my to-dos as I go through my emails. A lot of people use their email as a means of a task list. Well, help yourself by decluttering your email and take those tasks out of your email and put them into your planner. And when it comes to this tablet and the split screen, this is an easy and great way to do this. And having that functionality to go right back to this quick launch of that split screen is really helpful. Now I can go ahead and even take that feature and load that on pretty much any page or any position that I want by just holding it and navigating it over to here. Another feature I find really convenient is a lot of times I want to get to quick apps. I can take my finger and slide across the top here, and I have the ability to edit this, but I can put in different shortcuts or different apps that I use all the time. So you can see I have my files, I have the ability to take a screenshot, my photos, and OneNote right here, and I can easily load that. Now, one thing that iPad does that I feel that's kind of a mess is their stage manager. I've never been able to really utilize that device to its fullest potential. And here I can simply swipe and make that full screen as you would expect. I can also take that and release it and bring it back to the space, and it can resize that. So where this is helpful again is if I have, say, a full screen open of my browser, I can go ahead and choose here. I can come in here and I can quick write a quick note right inside this split screen effect. So that there is a quick look at the OnePlus tablet and the iPad as a comparison. Now, like we said earlier in the video, there is definitely an operating difference when it comes to the ecosystems of these devices. But when it comes to being able to use digital note-taking, the hardware, and even the accessories, there's a lot of comparables that make these devices sort of similar, but yet unique to themselves. Now, when I look at the pricing of these products and I add up the cost of what it is for the iPad, the pencil, and the folio keyboard, or even the Magic Keyboard for that matter, and then compare that to the price of the OnePlus Pad, the keyboard, and the pencil, there's a significant savings with this price. And that alone makes it attractive. So if you're someone that is used to use an Android platform and was looking at a new tablet, but you know the quality build that of the iPad, this Android tablet is probably for you. If you're someone that has been using the iPad and love that ecosystem and love everything that Apple has to offer, then I honestly feel that you may want to stick with the iPad, as myself. But when it comes to looking at a mixed bag of devices and you want to have a tablet for a better price that has a lot of same functionality that of the iPad, but yet you're gonna be able to synchronize it across various environments and platforms like Windows, Android, and Apple, well, this device runs OneNote, so it's gonna allow you to share all those notes across all those different platforms, keeping that synchronization wherever you are. So that is my take on it. Go ahead, hit the comments. Let me know your thoughts on which device you like. We didn't dive into a lot of hardware specs in this case. That's not something I generally do. I generally talk about how you can get productivity and return from using the device. So if I did that and brought you one piece of information that's helpful, please go ahead and like this video. And if you want to learn more about planning, tech reviews for it, how to create productivity in your life, go ahead and subscribe to our channel. Again, I'm Brandon Bonhoeffer, creator and founder of the Key to Success Planner. And Lord willing, guys, we'll see each other in another video. Stay tuned.